Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. So I know I'm a little bit late on these Merry Mondays. I'm so sorry. I had a computer issue last night when I tried to get this video out late last night and it would not go for anything. So you might hear my voiceover saying it is Merry Mondays. That's because this video was pre-recorded yesterday. But we're going to go ahead and act like this didn't happen and the next videos will be out Monday mornings. So let's continue to watch. Now kicking off Merry Mondays, I'm going to go ahead and put on some tape because I was feeling a sharp edge line again this day, as you can see. And I'm just applying tape. My brows are already done. I'm using the Benefit Air Patrol Primer to go ahead and prep my lids. I actually really like this product. It's one of my favorite products from Benefit. One of my only favorite products from Benefit. If you guys want an updated brow tutorial 2016, let me know down below because I've been using e.l.f. lately. I'm also taking a Morphe stippling brush to go ahead and blend that out. Now after I make this face, I'm just trying to figure out what's next. So I'm taking this but it's from Morphe. And I'm taking my 35O palette and I'm mixing these two shades here, like a burnt orange and kind of like a light tan kind of sable-y color. And this is going to be my transition color in my crease and I am blending that all in the crease. Now going back into that Morphe palette, I'm going to go ahead and take a darker shade, and that's this color here, and I'm going to blend this in my outer crease into the middle crease. I'm not bringing this too far in, as you can see, like not all the way in the inner corner, but a decent amount. I'm really blending this in because you guys know I like my crease to be warm. I'm also putting this all on my lid just for to prep for the next shadow color. Going back into my brush, well, I'm taking a new brush from Morphe, and I'm going back into the 35O palette, and I'm taking this dark brown here, and I'm focusing this in the outer corner just to build that depth. I'm now going to remove the tape because I got my lines as sharp as I want it to be. And I'm just going to continue to go ahead and blend. Now going into my Morphe palette, 35O palette again, I am taking this color here and this is going to be my all over lid shade. And I'm just going to apply this with another Morphe brush. As you guys can know, I really love this company if you haven't noticed. And I'm just applying this all over my lid. It's kind of like a coppery look. It was supposed to be matte, like a matte brown eye, and then I don't know, this particular lid color was calling me, so I just add it. It's like a satiny color. It's very pretty though. Now I'm just going to go ahead and blend out. Now I'm going to get ready to prep my foundation. I'm going to my Ulla Henderson Sheer Transformation Cream. I can't speak today. And I'm going to go ahead and moisturize my bottom part of my face. My forehead was already moisturized with my OU Gel Mattifier from First Aid Beauty. Once I put this in, I'm putting my primer, which is the Nivea Aftershave Balm for Men, and I'm applying that all over. Now I'm taking my Marc Jacobs foundation. This is a full coverage remarkable foundation. I believe this is Coca Light. I'm taking this with a Morphe 439 brush. And okay, now there are some ups and downs with this foundation. You guys will see that this foundation does appear a little bit lighter than me, but it's actually my color. I don't know why, when I look from my mirror and looked in the camera, it looked different. Maybe it's the saturation. I have to work on that. But the only problem I have with this foundation is that it kind of oxidizes a little bit white. I talk about this in a video, but you know how you have a foundation and sometimes it oxidizes darker than your skin. Well, this in certain areas you will see like legit a white cast. Like I see like white settling forming white, and this happens around my mouth when it's not set properly. I don't know, maybe that's how the formula is. I don't know if anybody else is talking about it, because I haven't seen a lot of people talk about this, but it has happened to me. Around my mouth area, it does get white. So I have to constantly pack and pack and pack just to set it so it won't turn white. Now, if you follow me on Snapchat, Mary_Binks, I actually show you in my Snapchat that it was oxidizing a little bit whitish. But this is the part where I told you that it looked fine in my mirror, but in the viewfinder of my camera, it looked a little bit off. Now I'm going to go ahead and highlight and contour. I'm using my usual font to color correct, and then I'm using Cool Tan. From all these concealers are LA Girl. I'm using Cool Tan to highlight, and then I'm going back in with the yellow corrector just to brighten up a little bit more. And I'm taking the Sigma 3D Kabuki brush, the big one, to go ahead and blend it out. And then, I don't know, it just wasn't doing it right, so I had to go back in with my Beauty Blender. My other brush is a little bit dirty, so, you know. But yeah, I don't know. I've seen other people talk about this foundation, and I haven't seen, like, you can see it now at the bottom part of my mouth, in certain areas of my face, it appears to have a white cast. You see it, my bottom part of my mouth. But once it's set and the powder is pressed in, it's not white anymore. But if it's not set properly, you will have a white cast. But yeah, that's the only downside to this foundation. It does last long, and it does cover a little bit, goes a long way. With this foundation, it's supposed to be two of the little dots that you see me couldn't go far as half of, from half a face will cover for medium coverage. Four like droppers on half a face would be full coverage. Not a lot is needed, but yeah, like I mentioned before, that's the only downside, is that it oxidizes white unless you set it properly. Would I recommend this foundation? I'm not 100% sure. Depending on your skin type, if you are looking for a full coverage foundation that is 24 hours, this one in Lancome would be your best bet. But if you don't want to do all the work to keep this foundation your skin color, then go ahead and go with Lancome. But I know one of my Sephorians, my coworkers at work, she loves this, and it don't do it on her, but it does it on me. So I don't know, maybe it's just the darker complexion colors that cast is white. But yeah, I'm just taking Beautiful Bronze from LA Girl just to contour my nose, because for some reason I wanted to be extra snatched on my nose today. Now I'm taking my Bobbi Brown Compact Cream Foundation Powder and Espresso. I believe it's Espresso. I'm not 100% sure. Yeah, because it's 11:53 and I'm doing this voiceover and all the products are away. But it will be in the description box by today or tomorrow. But yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and blend all of that out. And I'm making sure I blend it correctly, because I don't want that white cast. Like, I get a white cast. Now in this video, I know I'm probably babbling. I don't know, like I mentioned before, that's the only thing about this foundation. If you have this foundation, y'all, and you guys have a problem with that particular white cast thing, let me know down below if you do. I mean, if you don't, then I wish I was you, but let me know if you do so I can know if I'm the only one who's having this problem. I'm just taking my under eye setting powder my HD powder from NYX, my new holy grail, just to go ahead and set my eye. And then I'm going in with my foundation brush just to clean up my contour to make my contour appear extra sharp. I'm going to go ahead and highlight the center of my chin because I failed to do it before. And then I'm setting everything with the powder. I went over with my Mineralize Skin Finish powder first, and then I went on a Sephora Press powder, just for the extra coverage. I'm going to go ahead and contour using my La Grace Cosmetics powder, shade 45. And just, you know, go ahead around my forehead as well. I originally applied a brown liner in my waterline, but then afterwards I was like, yeah, I need to do blue. So this is OCC Multi-Purpose Pencil in the shade Pool Boy, which is this gorgeous baby sky blue color. And I put it in my waterline, just a little bit on the top tip of my bottom lash line. Now I'm taking a Nika King liner. I'm not sure what the name is. I will list it down below. And I'm putting this on first, and then I'm applying the lipstick Velvet Teddy all over my lips, and then I'm going in with Peach Stock. But as you can see, I was looking a little Dave Chappelle, in my opinion. I didn't think, you know, I needed liner. So I went ahead and took the Nika K dark brown liner, and I went ahead to go ahead and just fix my lips and line it. I am first taking Bobbi Brown Bronze Glow for my first highlight all over the face, and then I am taking Becca Opal to follow up just to give it that extra light. Followed by these highlighters, I am also going to go ahead and apply some mascara. I'm using the travel-sized version of the NARS Audacious Mascara. When it comes to mascaras, I like to get travel-sized because I own so many mascaras, I'm not going to finish a full size by the time I open up the next mascara. So yeah, I'm using this, and I really like this mascara. This is one of my favorite mascaras, which is the NARS Audacious Mascara. Then I'm taking my Becca Opal, the pressed powder again, and I'm going to apply this as an inner corner highlight. And then that is it for my look, you guys. Okay, you guys, and this is my final look. I've been having this Marc Jacobs foundation for almost a year now, and I've used this a handful of times, and I had this when it first came out. Legitimately, when it first came out, I got it. And a lot of people have been raving about this, and I wanted to show you guys the truth. With this foundation, around the mouth area, it does, you know how some foundations oxidize darker? This does give you a white cast oxidation. I found it white cast oxidation around the mouth area and around the beauty blender. So say for example, while you're working on your concealer, while the concealer is beginning to set, for some reason this starts to oxidize a little bit of white. So in order for me to kind of correct that, I use my pressed powder and I push it into the foundation so that the color would absorb into the foundation and stay the color of my skin. But yeah, overall I do love this foundation. This foundation is full coverage. You saw how much I put on and covered everything. I do have a blemish poking out here, but it's fine. Now for some reason on camera, when I first put it on, it didn't look like my shade, but trust me, that's why I showed you in the video that it's me. It's me, alright? But yeah. So, this foundation, I actually like this foundation. It's a little bit workable. I like it. Highlight, you guys see the routine. So yeah. So, I recorded this on Monday, so I'm going to try to get this up for you Monday night. I told you guys I'm going to do Merry Mondays. Yeah, I ended up uploading, I got too happy last week and uploaded two videos last week when I was supposed to upload one on Monday. So yeah, that's what happened. But yeah, my highlight not on fleek enough. Let me add a little bit more. Just a little tad bit more. There we go. That's better. But yeah, thank you guys for watching my channel. Thank you guys for supporting me. Thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. And like always, I will see you in my next video. And without further ado, let me go finish getting ready for work. I'll see you guys next time, y'all. Bye.